Morning, everyone. Well, we're getting ready to do sunflowers, and let me show you the working dogs we're going to be using for sunflowers. One of them is going to be this N7 that, for some reason, it's worked about the best in sunflowers for us. And let's go over what we kind of had to do before sunflowers on it. A little bit of fix up, but one of the things we did is we put a new drive belt on from the engine for the machine. That was one thing we did. And then for another reason is, another thing that kind of works on these ones are these under shoe. We got the rubber bushings on the shoe that seem for some reason go out quite often on this one. I'm not sure why, but it's what happens to it. And we put new rubbers in every couple years possibly. But what happens is the sieves are in there and the shoe goes back and forth. And that's actually what shakes the sunflowers away from all the chaff and sticks. And other thing we've done is tighten up elevator chains and make sure all our belts are ready for when we're ready to go. This side also we put new rubber bushings in on top. And on the bottom, the ones in the back, for some reason, seem to hold pretty well. But this will be one of the working dogs that we'll be using for sunflowers. The other one we're going to be using is this R70. Let's walk out here and take a look at it. This one here is the one that ran the rock through during soybeans. And we had to end up restringing the whole fan, putting new blades in the fan. The first set of blades we got were the wrong ones for this machine, and we end up trashing them again. And then another thing happened is, I'm not sure what happened, but the shaft on the end here got bent. So we had to go through and repair that. But we put new cylinder bar in this one. Let's look, see if we can see the fins in here, the fins, blades. But yeah, we had to put a new back plate in. When the last fan went out, it blades, it took the back plate out with it. But for this one, it's, for the most part, it's pretty good to go. But these sunflowers are hard on these machines, hard on tires, hard on the concave, just all around. It's kind of hard on them. So I try to use the older ones until these things are wore out completely, which for the most part, they're probably starting to get there. Take a look at the head. What they call a lucky sunflower pan is what catches the seed. When the head, if the head gets hit, it catches the seed and feeds it into the header. Another machine we'll use is this R72. If we have enough manpower on it, this is the one that the return elevator, when we were doing soybeans, tore the chain and kind of wrecked the elevator. So we put a new chain in it and belts, everything seemed to be good in it. So we'll see if, like I said, if we have enough manpower, we'll go ahead and use this one also. These fingers here, if you see them, they're for when sunflowers are down, or and it actually picks them off the ground and it'll lift them up and feed them in the header. And this dog we got in the shop here, kind of leave him sitting in here. We get to use him to go to church on Sunday. So people kind of give me or joke about it anyway, but it's in here. If we need it as a backup, it's here. So there's a good start for sunflowers. Well, in the beginning of combining sunflowers, let's take a check and see how this R72 is doing for us. It's about 37 degrees today. It's not too warm. We'll give it a shot. The light ones are the ones that are blown out, but for the most part, looks pretty good.